欢迎收听中文播客，大家好，我是迪露。
Hey guys, I'm John. This is an intermediate lesson.
今天呢，我们要说中国的一个 province。
哪一个？
山西，山西。
Alright, so that's two first tones, 山西。 There's another province which sounds very similar, right?
对，另外一个是陕西，陕西。
So that one's third tone, first tone. That's the one where 西安 is, right?
啊，对。
And when you write the third tone one, 陕西, in English, you usually write S-H-A-A-N-X-I.
Oh, 是吗?
Right, but that's not the one we're talking about today.
对对对,我们今天说的是两个第一声,山西,山西。
Plus the two characters in that name are super simple.
就是 mountain 的那个山,然后西就是 west 的那个西。
Right, so if you don't know anything about this province, that's okay, because you're about to learn. Here we go.
你回来啦，去山西玩得怎么样？
挺好的，山西的面食真好吃。
是吧？去了哪些地方？
去了平遥古城，有很多古代的东西，还有很好吃的平遥牛肉。
有没有带点回来？
带了，一会儿给你吃。哦，我还去了乔家大院。
乔家大院怎么样？
很大，很有特色。
五台山去了吗？
去了，挺好玩的。有很多寺庙和和尚，
有意思。
不过在山西不能穿白衣服。
为什么？
山西煤太多了，白衣服很快就变黑了。
Okay, so in this dialogue, someone went to Shanxi and came back to tell about it, right?
是的。这个女孩问山西玩得怎么样。
So the guy said, 挺好的, pretty good, right? And then what did he like about the place?
面食。他说,山西的面食真好吃。
Okay, so 面食, that's a fourth tone, second tone. And is that like 面条, like noodles?
面条是面食的一种。那面食指的是用面粉做的吃的东西。
All right, hold on. You said 面条, noodles are a type of 面食。
对。
And 面食 refers to food made with flour?
对,比如说馒头就是一种面食。
So what about just, you know, bread?
Bread 啊? Bread 是外国的东西。
面包不算面食。
中国人可能觉得面食就是面条、馒头,还有一些饼这种。
Okay. So anyway, 山西's 面食 is quite tasty.
对，然后我们看一下他去了哪些地方。第一个地方是平遥古城，平遥古城。
All right, so we can break this down into two parts. The first part is basically just a name, right?
是的，是一个地方的名字，叫平遥，两个第二声。
Okay, and then the second part tells us a little bit more about what kind of place it is. What's the second part?
古城，古城，第三声和第二声。
Okay, third tone, second tone.Literally, it means ancient city, right?
是的。
So it's a very old-style town?
就是一个古代的城市。
Okay, and then we have the word 古代 in the dialogue as well, right?
对,古代,第三声和第四声。
Right, so 古代 refers to ancient times, possibly classical times.Exactly how you define what 古代 is, when it ended, is a little bit tricky, but it actually ended...In the past several hundred years.
如果你要 define it exactly, 应该是1840年之前都是古代。
So before 1840 is 古代。
对,但是我们不会分得这么清楚,古代就是很早以前的东西。
But when I hear 古代, I usually think, oh, 1,000 years ago, 2,000 years ago.
在课文里面呢,我们说的是这个古城,这个平遥古城,它确实比较老,但是也没有这么老。
Yeah, it doesn't trace back to like thousands of years ago.
应该没有啊。
It's hundreds of years old. Okay.
而且呢，那边的牛肉很好吃。
So, 平遥牛肉 is a famous thing to eat there.
这是应该是一个 brand.
It's not hundreds of years old, right?
那我就不知道了，有可能。
Maybe it is. Okay, but anyway, it's good.
那我们看一下第二个地方，叫乔家大院。 乔家大院。
All right, we can break this one into two parts too, right? What's the first part?
乔家，乔家。
So this 乔, second tone is a family name.
没错，这个乔是一个姓。
Okay, and then 家 refers to their family.
是的，乔家大院。
So 大院，院 is like a courtyard or something. So 大院 is like a big compound.
哎，这个乔家大院，你不要觉得它只是一个 yard， 它里面有二十多个院子，而且有三百多间房间。
All right, so many, many rooms. It's a big compound.
是的。
And this, okay, so 乔家大院 is a famous place in Shanxi to learn about history, right?
嗯，是的。而且呢，这个地方很有特色，很有特色。
So 特色，two fourth tones, that's like a distinguishing feature or characteristic.
嗯。
But if we say 很有特色, like has a lot of distinguishing features or characteristics,
这个词在我们旅游的时候常常会用到。
Right, you often use it when you're traveling because you see something that's like very distinctive of the local culture.
哎、
right?
没错。
Like maybe the minority group that lives from that region or just the local people, they do things in a special way.、
嗯、
so then you remark,
很有特色，很有特色。
Greetings everyone and welcome to Chinese Pod Trivia!Our first question is, how long will it take you to become an intermediate Chinese speaker using the Chinese Pod app? Is it A, the rest of your life? B, you should already be an intermediate speaker? C, 3 months? Or D, Chinese Pod has an app?
You should already be in...
Ooh, that is incorrect. The correct answer is C, 3 months. That's right. Head over to ChinesePod.com now to register for your access to over 4,000 lessons.Get the Chinese Pod app now on Google Play or the App Store.
Yeah, so if you ever watch Chinese travel programs, they say that about like everything. 很有特色. So it can be about food, and it can also be about like crafts or clothing.
嗯，没错，这个吃的东西很有特色，衣服很有特色.
All right, so that's very useful when you're traveling. And then they go on to talk about a mountain, right?
对，这是山西另外一个很有特色的地方。叫五台山，五台山。
Okay, so that's the name of the mountain. Third tone, second tone, and of course, first tone.
嗯，没错，五台山。那这个五台山呢，是一座非常有名的佛教名山。
So this is a mountain that's famous in the Buddhist tradition in China.
对。
Right, we have other Chinese pod lessons about that in the higher levels, but in this lesson, we just hear one of them, and it is...
五台山。五台山。
Okay, so you mentioned it was a Buddhist mountain. So on the Buddhist mountain, we can expect to find...
啊，那当然山上就有很多的寺庙和和尚。有很多寺庙和和尚。
Okay, the first word meant temple, right? Like a Buddhist temple?
是的，寺庙，寺庙，两个第四声。
Okay, two fourth tones. So in Shanghai, we have a Buddhist temple, a very famous one in the center of the city, right?
哎，对对对，有一个叫城隍庙，城隍庙。
Okay, so you notice that the name ends with 庙, and there's another one.
你是说静安寺吗？
Right, and that one ends in 寺. So when you talk about the specific name of a temple, they usually end in 寺 when they're really big Buddhist temples.Occasionally, 廟 for the smaller ones. But when you talk about a temple without saying the specific name, you call it...
寺廟, 寺廟.
All right, that's the general term for temples.
对.
And then, of course, the people in the temples are...
Tourists.
Not just tourists, the ones that work in the temples that live in the temples.
和尚, 和尚.
All right, so those are the monks, the Buddhist monks. So the tones are...
第二声和轻声。
Can you say it again?
和尚，和尚。
Okay, this 轻声 sounds a little bit like fourth tone, but anyway, this is the way you say monk in Chinese, 和尚、right?
是的，那山西还有一件很有趣的事情。
A very interesting thing, what would that be?
就是你不能穿白色的衣服。
Is this true?
是真的呀。
Okay, and the reason is?
因为山西的煤太多了。
So 煤, second tone means coal.
对，就是那种黑色的。东西很脏。
Okay, because there's lots of coal being burned and mined. Is it mined or?
还有 delivered, transferred.
And that's what creates the coal dust everywhere.
嗯，是的。 山西没太多，那么白衣服很快就变黑了。
Okay, so white clothing quickly turns black. How do we say turns black?
变黑，变黑。
So 变, fourth tone, meaning to change, to turn. And then 黑, of course, is black. So we can do this for any color, is that right?
对，你可以说树叶变黄了。
If your face turns red?
脸变红了。
Okay, or what about turns white?
变白了。
But that's not going to happen in Shanxi, huh?
应该没有，只有变黑了。
All right, I have one other question, a grammar question from this dialogue. So when we're talking about the 平遥牛肉, the girl wanted to know if the guy brought any back, right?
对。
And what did he say?
他说一会儿给你吃，一会儿给你吃。
So this 一会儿, that means in a little while, right?
对啊，就是等一会儿。
So it's the same as 等一会儿。
是的，是的，就是等一会儿，过一会儿。
All right, they're all the same.
是的。
All right, I noticed this 会儿 is third tone, right?
对对对，第三声，一会儿。
All right, got it. Let's listen to that dialogue one more time.
你回来啦，去山西玩得怎么样？
挺好的，山西的面食真好吃。
是吧？去了哪些地方？
去了平遥古城。有很多古代的东西，还有很好吃的平遥牛肉。
有没有带点回来？
带了，一会儿给你吃。哦，我还去了乔家大院。
乔家大院怎么样？
很大，很有特色。
五台山去了吗？
去了，挺好玩的，有很多寺庙和和尚。
有意思。
不过在山西不能穿白衣服。
为什么？
山西煤太多了，白衣服很快就变黑了。
All right, so if any of you are planning a trip to Shanxi, there are a couple places you want to keep in mind.
我们来复习一下。第一个呢是平遥古城。平遥古城。
All right, 平遥, and then another one?
乔家大院。乔家大院。
Okay, what else?
还有五台山，五台山。
All right, and of course, on the mountain, there are a lot of...
有很多寺庙和和尚。
Okay, and in the eating department?
我们有一些 tips, 比如说山西的面食很好吃。
And what about meat?
那你要去平遥古城的话，一定要记得买平遥牛肉。
Okay, and the final tip is about clothing, right?
最后呢，就是去山西的时候不能穿白衣服。
Because?
因为山西的煤太多了。
All right, so I think that kind of wraps up for this lesson. Anything else you want to say about 山西?
没有了。我觉得这个课文帮助很大。我也想去山西看一看。
And if you've been to 山西, we'd like to hear about it on ChinesePod.com. If we missed anything, you can share it with us.
对。快快来给我们留言吧。我们今天的课就先到这里。下次再见。
再见。
As usual, ChinesePod provides an extensive selection of learning materials for this lesson on its website, www.chinesepod.com. You can access this lesson directly with the lesson number 2036. So just go to www.chinesepod.com/2036 and you will find a transcript, vocabulary, and much more. The link again, www.chinesepod.com/2036.